beauty and gray, a wise leader. Once upon a time, there was a deer who was the leader of a herd of 1,000. He had 2 sons. One was very slim and tall, with bright, alert eyes and smooth, reddish fur. He was called Beauty. The other was gray in color, also slim and tall, and he was called Gray. One day, after they were fully grown, their father called Beauty and Gray to him. He said, "I'm now very old, so I cannot do all that is necessary to look after this big herd of deer. I want you, my 2 grown-up children, to be the leaders, while I retire from looking after them all the time. We will divide the herd, and each of you will lead 500 deer." So it was done. In India, when the harvest time comes, the deers are always in danger. The rice is at its tallest, and the deer cannot help but go into the paddies and eat it. To avoid the destruction of their crops, the human beings dig pits, set sharp stakes in the ground, and build stone traps, all to capture and kill the deer. Knowing this was the season, the wise old deer called the 2 new leaders to him. He advised them to take the herds up into the mountain forest, far from the dangerous farmlands. This was how he always saved the deer from being wounded or killed. Then he would bring them back to the lowlands after the harvest was over. Since he was too old and weak for the trip, he would remain behind in hiding. He warned them to be careful and have a safe journey. Beauty set out with his herd for the mountain forest, and so did Gray with his. The villagers all along the way knew that this was the time the deer moved from the low-lying farmlands to the high countryside. So they hid along the way and killed the deers as they passed by. Gray did not pay attention to his father's wise advice. Instead of being careful and traveling safely, he was in a hurry to get to the lush mountain forest. So he moved his herd constantly, during the night at dawn and dusk, and even in broad daylight. This made it easy for the people to shoot the deer and graze herd with bows and arrows. Many were killed, and many were wounded, only to die in pain later on. Gray reached the forest with only a few deer remaining alive. The tall, sleek, red-furred Beauty was wise enough to understand the danger to his moving herd. So he was very careful. He knew it was safer to stay away from the village and from all humans. He knew it was not safe in the daytime or even at dawn or dusk. So he led his herd wide around the villages and moved only in the middle of the night. Beauty's herd arrived in the mountain forest safe and sound, with no one killed or injured. The 2 herds found each other and remained in the mountains until well after the harvest season was over. Then they began to return to the farmland country. Gray had learned nothing from the first trip. As it was getting cold in the mountains, he was in a hurry to get to the warmer lowlands. So he was just as careless as before. Again, the people hid along the way and attacked and killed the deer. All Gray's herds was killed, later to be eaten or sold by the villagers. Gray himself was the only one to survive the journey. Beauty led his herd in the same careful way as before. He brought back all 500 deer, completely safe. While the deers were still in the distance, the old chief said to his doe, "Look at that deer coming back to us. Beauty has all his followers with him. Gray comes limping back alone, without his whole herd of 500. Those who follow a wise leader with good qualities will always be saved. Those who follow a foolish leader who is careless and thinks only for himself will fall into trouble and be destroyed." After some time, the old deer died and was reborn as he deserved. Beauty became chief of the herd and lived a long life, loved and admired by all. The moral is, a wise leader puts the safety of his followers first.